You called, madame?
Aegis, thank heavens you're here. We're under siege.
In the courtyard. One of the king's creatures.
It seems determined to destroy the chateau walls. It's as if it came here for us.
Here is the key to the gate. It will lead you to the courtyard.
Hurry. Our lives are in your hands.
thing, it's staring at you.
You're safe, madame.
Mon Dieu. Ages. Why did this abomination attack us?
I think you know, madame. You saw how it obeyed you when you ordered it to stop fighting.
I don't understand a word of this nonsense.
I'm afraid your guardian angel seems to have a few screws loose, my queen.
No. You must listen to me. That creature was not trying to destroy you, madame. It was trying to be near you. Listen to your heart. You know what it was. You know whose soul animated those cogs.
Stop it, please. Just stop.
You must know the truth. Everything is there, written in the king's own hand. How he ordered your son to be put to death. How he bound his soul to the machine I just destroyed. How they were unable to control this hateful thing.
My baby.
Oh, my queen.
My poor angel. In the hell he suffered. Wanted only to seek his mother's comfort.
No. No.
Curse you, Louis. The butcher king. Murderer. Destroyer of innocence. He will pay for this unspeakable crime with his own head. I swear it on my life.
No, Antonia, my dear friend. Do not give in to this madness.
Leave us, Aegis. I must speak privately with Madame de Polignac.
Very well, madame.
God, by God. We're not gonna just leave her there. She'll be eaten by rats.
What would you have us do? Are you willing to risk your life just to go bury her?
Absolutely not. But still, what a sorry sight.
A day has passed and I can still hear her cries. It was blood curdling.
Who could be so cowardly as to attack a half-crazed woman?
Oh, I'd wager that it was a stranger I saw hanging around here for 2 days.
Oh yeah, I remember. A sort of strong man with a pockmarked face, wasn't he? A frightening face, really.
He was asking about the Countess. And he was insistent, the brute. But I knew how to hold my tongue. You know me.
But the cutthroat must have succeeded in the end. God knows how he tricked the Countess into letting him in.
That's true. Our Countess was a highly suspicious woman. But why did he want to arm her?
No doubt it was because of those old rumors. As crazy and poor as she was, it seems that she kept a small treasure hidden under her bed. All that remained of her aristocratic life, it seems.
The poor thing. This is not the work of an automat, but of a common thug, no doubt. Now I must bring the terrible news to Monsieur de Mirabeau. sure that no one will use it against the people of Paris? Or shall I entrust it to the general of ahead? See to it the citoyen Lavoisier's wish is granted. Too much blood has been shed already. To our Mirabeau. Unfortunately, I come bearing sad news.
Go on, Aegis. There is no need to spare me. This is about my mother, isn't it?
Indeed. The Countess is no longer of this world.
Yes, yes. It was to be feared. I knew she was lost a long time ago. The poor woman. At last, she has been delivered from the madness that drove her into the gutter.
It gets worse.
Worse, you say?
Your mother did not die of poverty. She was killed.
Murdered? No. No, my father. The rabid dog made good on his threat. May he roast in the fires of hell for all eternity. As for you, Bishop, do you finally understand the man's true nature? How much longer will you protect this demon?
I share your grief, Monsieur de Mirabeau, but the secrets of...
Enough! You sanctimonious bigot! Is it not enough for you to serve the people absurd fables that condemn them to ignorance? Must you also submit to the whims of a malicious old brute? The scourge of his own family? Speak! Speak now, or so help me, I will send you to meet your maker.
Please, monsieur, let us not get carried away. Out of respect for your grief, and given the extraordinary circumstances, I consent to enlighten you.
I am listening, monseigneur.
I admit that your father is an unusual person, inhabited by an anger whose source is undetermined. He blamed you, your sister, and your poor mother for all of his misfortunes. I stayed by his bedside an entire night. I preached about mercy and the example of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Ha! That must have gone over well.
Do not mock me, Monsieur de Mirabeau. At dawn, I finally got Monsieur le Marquis to see the error of his ways. Before God, he extended forgiveness to all those he had previously condemned.
However, he did not give up his plans for revenge. The fate reserved for my mother is proof of this.
In fact, Monsieur, he did. He even gave me a leather wallet containing, in his words, the instrument of your punishment. He asked me to dispose of it. Unfortunately, your mother's fate was already sealed. Orders had been given. There was nothing more that could be done. The poor soul. He was in tears, his body racked with sobs.
My heart breaks to hear it. What was in the wallet?
I don't know, monsieur. I did not open it.
In that case, I ask you to give it to me now.
I cannot, monsieur. When I was captured, the wallet fell into the hands of the Comte de Cagliostro.
No, Aegis. Do you realize what this means? This wallet contains my father's sentences for his children. Me, of course, but also my sister, the Marquise de Cabri. You must find it at all costs. Our fate is in your hands. Cagliostro must have put it in a safe place, somewhere known only to him.
The Marquise de Cabri, dites-vous?
Yes, that is my sister Louise's title.
Fortune favors you today. It so happens that I already have this wallet. It was in a secret workshop by the Tuileries, where the Count conducts his sinister experiments.
Oh, how fortunate. What does it contain?
Two envelopes addressed to the Lieutenant General de Police. One of them had this letter in it. It concerns your sister, the Marquise de Cabri.
Let's see. A lettre de cachet signed by my father. He gave orders to have my sister locked up in a convent. His unique variety of fatherly love is unmistakable. What was in the second envelope?
It is empty.
Empty? Mon Dieu. You don't have to be a genius to guess that it contained a similar document, this time concerning myself. If the envelope was empty, it means that this letter has already been delivered to its recipient. By Cagliostro, no doubt. The monster must have felt a perverse sense of joy as he devoured its contents. Aegis, you must retrieve this letter at all costs. If the Lieutenant General attaches a seal and gives it to his underlings at the Châtelet, I am done for.
Where does this Lieutenant General reside?
Right by the fortress. He's a dutiful man and prides himself on never straying too far from it. Please hurry, I beg of you.
Citoyen Robespierre.
Madame.
As for the lanterns...
Did Monsieur de Laclos tell you the secret of his explosive cannonball?
No. We didn't talk about it.
That's a pity. Without his help, our strategy is doomed to failure. Let's see. I know he's close to Monsieur Marat, the patriotic journalist. He's currently in hiding in the quarries of Montmartre. But please, do not breathe a word of this to the Marquis de Lafayette. Those two are at daggers drawn. It would certainly end in a bloodbath.
Goodbye, Citoyen. And death. Citoyen Lavoisier.
What can I do for you, Aegis?
I found the powder. It was at the Bastille.
Did you do what needed to be done?
Yes. There is nothing more to fear from it.
What do you mean, nothing more to fear from it?
I flooded the cellars where the powder was stored.
Bon sang! Lavoisier! Why did you put our fate in the hands of a cursed machine?
This machine, as you say, just saved you from certain annihilation.
No, you have rendered us impotent.
Come now, monsieur, get a hold of yourself.
Mon Dieu, everything I attempt seems doomed to fail. I fear we no longer have any chance of winning this war.
Please, calm yourself. What you fear is the loss of your own personal interests. Everyone here is convinced of this. Goodbye, Citoyen Lavoisier. And down with despotism. Citoyen Raymond.
Can I help you, Aegis?
Goodbye, and may... Monseigneur.
What can I do for you, Aegis?
Goodbye, vive la...
If that is your deal, then so be it.
Can I help you, Aegis?
I hope so, Abbot. Our salvation is at stake.
I am listening.
the lettre de cachet that had Monsieur de Mirabeau so terrified. I shall deliver it to him shortly. Citoyen Mirabeau, here is the letter sent by your father to the Lieutenant General de Police. You were right.
Oh. Mon Dieu. So this is what the Coeur had in store for me. A new lettre de cachet with a royal seal. He sentenced me to spend the rest of my days in the Chateau de Vincennes. To return to the cell where he had me locked up 12 years ago. Those 10 square feet where I lay at death's door for 42 months on end. 14 seasons spent with chattering teeth, coughing up a bucket full of bile and blood every day.
Your own father had you thrown in jail.
Alas, such is the sad truth.
What crime did he hold you to be guilty of?
He disapproved of the follies of the young man I was back then. And my love for a certain someone. A woman whom an unjust law kept me apart from. I was free and besotted with happiness, Aegis. And that was a crime in the eyes of my father, the Marquis. I sullied the Mirabeau name, so he felt it necessary to steal my youth and clap his wayward son in irons.
What does this letter matter in the face of the mortal peril that hangs over all the king's enemies?
You must put yourself in my shoes to understand. If the king wins this war, he will send all the brave men here to the scaffold. And I am certain they will climb the steps with their heads held high. But if you hadn't taken that letter, I would have suffered a far darker fate. Louis the Mad would have made it his duty to respect my father's last wishes. But I would rather die, whether a hero or a coward, than return to Vincennes. There is no worse hell on earth than that infernal dungeon.
Was there no trial?
One would imagine. Those damned lettres de cachet. For centuries, a powerful man, whether a king or a father, needs simply put pen to paper, and an innocent man is thrown into prison. The poor soul sees neither judge nor lawyer. In the space of an hour, he moves from the light into darkness. And his cries for help fall futilely on the cold stone of the dungeon walls. I am just one of many victims, whose ranks range from the most famous to the most lowly, from Voltaire and Diderot to the unfortunate children whose dark fates will never be known. In any case, I must now express my eternal gratitude, even though no words, no matter how eloquent, can express its depth. I owe everything to you, Aegis. You, who've broken my chains forever. Whatever happens now, I will be free to live or die for the nation. As for the Marquis de Mirabeau, that criminal whom misfortune chose as my father, let us consider him dead, shall we? Let him choke on loneliness and regret once and for all.
Are you making progress, Madame?
Yes, I'm working on it. Who is Monsieur de Laclos?
A brilliant writer whose pen has shaken, but is also to his great...
Dites-moi, Monsieur Marat.
I've in my... These vamp chief among the... Not content. It seems...
Who are your...
Patriot... My...
Members...
Would you...
In a...
Le flan...
The mark...
Sane... With advers...
I must gather the three echoes.
This time, it's over for me. The printers was ransacked, and I barely escaped from the guards sent to arrest me. I must disappear, and hope that things will one day turn to my advantage.
In truth, the timing is excellent. According to my informants, the king is planning a coup de force against the Third Estate. I think it's high time for all of us to go underground with you. Once we're hidden in the catacombs, we can prepare a counter-offensive in peace.
Does the Duke approve of this withdrawal?
No, oh, that fool. He's indecisive as usual. Always busy dreaming about his cousin's crown. But I've prepared the terrain. He will let me do as I please, as long as I serve his interests.
Laclos, you're alive.
Platoon, ready. Fire at will. Oh, Signor, God, we can't stop them. They're upon us. Fixed bayonets.
The fighting has stopped. It's over. Voyez, the huntress Diana appeared to us. She's the one who saved you.
But the troops, where are the troops?
You are the only survivor, Laclos.
No. We were so close. But those machines... An entire battalion would have been unable to defeat them. We were forced to retreat. Chased into these tunnels by the automats.
It was madness to attempt an attack on the Bastille.
You're wrong. I'm a military man. It was a bold maneuver, but it was a calculated risk. After all, that old fortress is a pile of stones with no buffers, curtain walls, or bastions. As for its garrison, our agents were certain. Only a handful of veterans should have been there. A single charge should have sufficed to disperse them. But the king made other arrangements. He increased the fortress's defenses and placed a swarm of automats at the service of a terrible machine.
Why did you launch this attack?
Three of our companions were held captive in the fortress. our best agents.
Agents?
Spies, if you prefer. We, the supporters of the Duc d'Orléans, have always worked in the shadows, within the Queen's entourage, in the tribunes of the Estates General, among the patriots in the clubs, amidst the rank and file in the army.
We have had some success, you have to admit.
What machinations have you discovered?
Enough to make Monsieur Marat's ink flow and bring down our rivals. Necker's speculations, Lafayette's dishonorable behavior, Mirabeau's corruption, and many darker secrets.
Such as Lafayette's plot to rescue the Dauphin and his sister Charlotte.
How on earth do you know that?
She seems as well informed as we are. Once again, the king has won.
That won't always be the case. But right now I have something urgent I must do. Tell me about this machine that guards the Bastille.
We were prepared to face an enemy, not an executioner. That thing, half butcher's block, half stocks, was designed to make heads roll.
Who captured you, monsieur?
There was some confusion in the fray. But Cagliostro was in charge. He was the one who ordered me to be shut up in that coffin. Then I was thrown into that awful place where I lost consciousness. After that, everything is a series of blurred visions with a voice that ordered me to kill again and again.
I went to the Bastille with the hope of questioning Eugène de Beaucanson.
Your creator? What did you want to know?
I wanted to learn the secret of his tireless automats.
Hello? Well, what can you tell us?
His fever took him before he could say anything.
Diable. It is hopeless.
What will you do now?
I'm left with no other choice. I will go and find the king. I will force him to stop these atrocities, no matter what it takes.
So? You're determined to risk everything. May your bravery meet with success. Because if you should fail, I fear that we are all doomed. Let's not stay here much longer, Marat. Let's head back to our burrow. There's still some wine left in this pub.
More than enough, Laclos. More than enough.
Wonderful. We'll drink to our broken dreams until this finally comes to an end.
Citoyen Laclos.
Can I help you, madame?
The representatives of the people are asking for your help, monsieur.
Who exactly are you talking about?
The patriots and representatives of the Third Estate who escaped the massacre.
I need names, madame.
Monsieur de Robespierre, Monsieur Lavoisier, the Marquis de Lafayette.
All these men have declared themselves enemies of the cause to which we have sworn allegiance to.
Is there any cause more important than saving the nation?
No, of course not. And what do these so-called defenders of the people want from me?
They believe they have found a way to neutralize the royal automats for good. And to do it, they beg you to give them one of the explosive cannonballs you invented.
Ma foi. If there is a way to stop these death machines, then I have a duty to assist them. But you must understand that I shall remain on my guard. When doing deals with the enemy, you must take precautions for when the game ends.
If that's how you feel, then by all means take steps to ensure your safety.
Let me think. Where are the representatives?
At the Couvent des Cordeliers.
Very well. Here's what we're going to do. I will go to the convent immediately and try to negotiate a truce. As for you, here is the key to a trunk in the next room. It contains a prototype of my cannonball, as well as the patents and pages that explain how to manufacture it. Bring all of this to me at the convent. However, do not give me anything unless I specifically request it. Is that clear?
Perfectly clear, monsieur. I will follow your instructions.
Madame, these gentlemen and I have come to an agreement.
That is good news.
We will resolve our differences when the time comes. The matter is settled.
You can count on it, Laclos. But despite your hostility and suspicion of treachery, I am and shall remain an enemy of the king. It is clear that we are fighting the same adversary.
Adversary? You are rather indulgent, Monsieur le Marquis. It seems that you are still fond of him, despite his heinous crimes.
Oh, de grâce.
Truly, the king is no more than a wild beast. And together, in large numbers, we will hunt him down.
Madame, please give the model and the engineering notes to Monsieur de Robespierre. However, you shall hold on to the patents. No one knows what the future may hold.
Let there be peace between you, gentlemen, for there is still much work to be done. We believe we now have a way to destroy the lanterns. Without them, The machines will no longer be able to carry out their sinister task. But it is still just a strategy, which needs to be tested. And even a conclusive experiment will not guarantee our success. Where will we find a working cannon? How will we get more vitriol? How will we make more cannonballs? Please, I ask each of you to set to work without delay.
Pour la nation, monsieur.
Pour la nation.
Pour la nation.
Pour la nation.
General Lafayette.
Do you need help, Aegis?
I was able to speak with Citoyen Marat and Citoyen Laclos.
Ah, the scoundrels. Did you force them to confess? Do you know what they did with the children?
They admitted to organizing the ambush at Gros Caillou.
Ah, cursed recreants. Cowardly corruptors of innocence. Where are they holding their prisoners? They must be rescued immediately.
They do not have Charlotte and the Dauphin.
Excuse me? They dare to claim that?
It is the truth. The ambush was a catastrophe. The king had gotten wind of your plans. Automats from Versailles slaughtered the kidnappers and seized the children. By now, the children will have been reunited with their father. There is little doubt about that.
Mon Dieu. Then it is from the clutches of that tyrant, in his own palace, that they must be saved. I fear that such an undertaking is doomed to failure, although there is no question of giving up.
Goodbye, General Lafayette. And down with the clockwork king.
Well put.